Hi everybody! I am back. It has been a while. Big things have happened since last I shared about our Scotland trip. We moved back to Michigan, and that in itself is a whole other video that is, it's super awesome, and just how everything's worked out. And if you would have asked me 3 months ago how I was doing about it, I probably would have been like, not good at all. But I can honestly say I'm super excited to be here, and just since we've been here, like the things that have been happening, so awesome. But I just have to share, because normally I don't like to make YouTube videos that are just like to make. I like to actually have something that's like, and so I have got to share this. This is like crazy. And if you hear a dog, there's a dog that's been grounded, Fitz. He is in his pen. Maybe I should let him out because that might get a little much. Yeah. Just ended up putting both in their cage, so. Sorry, guys. So, since moving, I've been like, it's not gonna work. Quiet. So since moving, I have been like, I don't know what has been happening, but I've just been like, so, just, I can't even, like going as ridiculous and as far and as deep and as crazy in with God than I ever have. And I don't know if it's because when I finally like bit the bullet about moving, I let go of like anger and any sort of walls that I built up because I didn't want to move so much. There was a lot of fear. But so since I made the decision to be excited and to be happy that we were being obedient, like that's amazing. It's been crazy. It's like a dam like has been broken and just floods of awesomeness have been coming forward. And the past couple weeks, all I have been thinking about is how we never need less of Jesus. And we never need him less than we did yesterday. Even if yesterday you needed him so badly, today you need him even more. It's blowing my mind how it all works, that you never need him less than you needed him at your worst moment today. Today you need him more, because today is the day that you have. Like, you need him more today than you needed on your worst day of your whole entire life, when you were on the end of your rope. You're like, I need you, Jesus. We still need him just that much. And God has been showing me this in like crazy ways. So I've been praying for this little girl, and I was praying, and God brought the story to me about when the woman who was not a Jew came to Jesus for healing, and he's like, am I supposed to give you the children's bread? And he probably didn't say it like that. But he's like, am I supposed to give you the children's bread? Like, his ministry was not, it was for the Jews and everything, but she ended up getting healed. And I was just thinking about when we say healing's for the children's bread, like it's so easy. It's bread from the table. Like, just go grab some bread. That's how easy healing is. But it hit me so hard that Jesus is the bread of life. He is the bread of life. Like, and I was blessed, like having a moment. I'm like, I'm so blown away right now because, oh my gosh. Guys, it's okay. They don't believe me. Jesus is the bread of life. He's referred to the bread of life on so many different ways. Like, he was the manna in the wilderness, what they needed every day. And this is what's amazing to me, guys, is that every day they had to go out and gather the manna and bring it back in and eat, the Israelites. But for the Sabbath, they had to go out the day before the Sabbath and gather twice as much bread, one for that day and one for the Sabbath. And it was blowing my mind because it's falling into place that because Jesus is the Sabbath, and there's an amazing teaching about the Sabbath rest. There's an amazing teaching of the Sabbath rest by Pastor Gary from Faith Life, which I can link. And on the Sabbath, they had more than enough. So when we come to Christ, we have more than enough Jesus for whatever possible thing we need. We have more than enough, but we still have to partake of the bread. Like, it would have done it would have done the Israelites no good if they had gathered the manna for the Sabbath and then didn't eat the manna. Like, they still had to eat it. So now it's getting even crazier because I kept thinking about it and pondering it, and then I heard like two messages in 2 weeks about how Passover when the Israelites were about to leave Egypt, how they ate the lamb. And that's where communion comes in, is they ate the lamb. They ate the lamb. And then the Bible says they went out of Egypt without one of them being sick. Every single man, woman, child, infant, whatever, they were not sick. There was no sickness in them. So then Jesus, fast forward thousands of years later, is at Passover talking about what we now take as communion. He's saying, the wine is my blood and my body that's broken for you is, you know, take that and you're partaking of me, and it's healing and it's all these things. But it's so much more. Like, it all just comes together that every single day we have inside of us all the Jesus that we need for whatever it is. Healing, it's not just, the healing is not just the children's bread as in easy access, but the children's bread is Jesus. Jesus is the children's bread. And that's what makes it so easy to access, is because the Holy Spirit lives within us. Jesus is like, guys, I'm leaving, but it's going to be better for you because the Holy Spirit is going to be inside of you. And we have access to the fullness of Christ on a daily basis. But a lot of times we save the manna for when we think we're going to need it most, or we forget about the manna until we need it most. But we need him every day. As much as we can get of him, we need it that day. And it's not that what we do today won't affect tomorrow, because God's outside of time. When we are praying in the spirit, or we're sowing, or we're doing these things, it does affect our tomorrow. But it would not affect our tomorrow if it wasn't for the time we're putting into him today. So I am challenging you guys, man, go deep. If you ever have read The Last Battle, it's the final book in the Chronicles of Narnia. It is my favorite. I love that book out of all the others. But when they finally get into the new Narnia, it is beautiful, but they realize it's like layered. And they keep saying to one another, further up and further in, further up and further in. And that's how God is. He's like this onion. And there's so many layers that we can't comprehend how deep we can go into God, how much we can know him, how much there is to know. I don't know it all. I will never know it all. And that's okay. I never want to be at a place where I know it all, because I know that I can never peel back all the layers of the onion. I'm like way up here, but it's because I'm so pumped. We cannot be the type of Christians who take the onion and scratch the surface when we need the onion. We have got to be the Christians that are digging into the core of the onion every day, so that when stuff happens, we don't have this scratch the surface knowledge of God. We aren't stuck in this hardened, familiar place. That's what's so crazy about religion, is that it's so familiar with who God is, what God says, Jesus, the Holy Spirit. It's so familiar with those things, but it's forgotten the power. Our relationship with God cannot get to a place of familiarity where we just remember and know, but it has to be an engaging process. This whole week, I can't stop crying. When I just can't stop crying anytime that I'm singing to God or praying and talking to him. Like, I'm just in my kitchen making hot chocolate, bawling my eyes out, because it's so real. He is so real. The depth of relationship that we've been invited to have is so real. I heard today, I was listening to a message, I think it was today, maybe it was yesterday, they're like, God will be, he's going to be the same God in eternity in heaven as he is right now. Like, it's not going to be any different. Our relationship with him now, we're still going to have this, he's going to be the same God that we get to know in heaven. Like, there's no barrier. The only barrier that we put on our depth of relationship with God is either lack of knowledge or lack of understanding. And they're different, because lack of knowledge is like the keys that you need to go deeper. Like, you know, things that you hear and read, when you're reading the word and you're listening to the word, like, you go deeper. And then understanding is having that spiritual revelation of aha, the aha moment where you've heard, aha, and then it becomes real and you can walk it out. We've got to be the deep, further up, further in Christians, because listen, all that God has desired for us become our desires when we get to know Him. There's something that is amazing that's coming that I can't wait to tell you guys about, but we were getting prayer about it, and the guy was, he was speaking, he's like, you think that these are the desires of your hearts, but they were my desire first. And I was just like weeping, because there is so much that God desires out of our lives. And at first, we hear all these things and we're like, But the more we know God, the more we pick up His heart on all of these things, and the more they become our desires, the more we identify with what He identifies with. It's love. The root of it is all is love. And now I'm getting to a place of rambling, so I'm going to stop. But please just redefine what it means to have a relationship with God. Redefine what it looks like. You know, there's people talk about a prayer closet, and those are wonderful. We need prayer closets. But we should not have limitations on when and where we have crazy moments with God. Most of my crazy moments with God have been in my kitchen making hot chocolate at this point in time, because I'm consuming stupid amounts of hot chocolate. You know? Like just shake it up. Today, I was like, I'm just gonna shake it up. And I'm like yelling and just praising God and being authentic and like dancing. And I've been dancing with my daughter, and we've been singing. And I want to break out of my definition of what a relationship with God looks like, because for so long my relationship with God has looked like sitting on a couch, drinking tea, reading my Bible, and writing devotions, and then worship. But I want something more. I want something more. And I'm gonna have to break those molds of familiar places with God. I want to get out, and I want to do things that are unexpected. And I'm encouraging you to do the same. Let's just be. Oh, I was singing today, and I was like, you are the lamb that was slain, but you are the lion that broke out of the grave. And a lot of times we see ourselves as lambs, but we're meant to be. And please, there's times and places for all these things. I'm just saying that maybe it looks different. That's where I am, guys. So I can't wait. Next video, we're gonna talk about, Tim's gonna be in it with me, and we're gonna talk about this move and how things are like crazy. And then I'm so pumped about February. I'm launching something amazing. I can't wait. Oh, it's gonna be so great. So pray for me, you guys. I'm praying for you, whoever's watching this. I just thank God for you. I thank God that He's not judging you, but that He is putting you in a place of influence, that He's putting you in a place of power, that He's putting you and posturing you for all that He desires to do in your life that you don't even know are your desires yet. So, okay.